Hi, so the highly anticipated reviews are in from the movie critics for Captain Marvel, and the current score is 87% on Rotten Tomatoes, and that has 93 reviews counted. So these are the reviews, average scores from 93 professional movie critics. But I want to point out that Rotten Tomatoes boosts up the scores because they call it a fresh tomato. If it's a certain score, they increase it to inflate the review score. But I'm just going to show you Metacritic. Now, this isn't fully settled yet. This might take another 2 days for it to be completed. But Metacritic has the scores from 35 critics, and the score is only 66%. So there's already a key difference between what Rotten Tomatoes is reporting and what Metacritic are reporting. And I'm struggling to understand how Rotten Tomatoes can say it's 87%. Because even if you counted another 66 scores from the remaining movie critics that haven't been reported by Metacritic yet, they would all have to be around 100 in order to get up to 87%. So Rotten Tomatoes is using what it does. It inflates the scores and calls them fresh tomatoes if they're above a certain score. So it's quite a misleading score. But if this trend continues on Metacritic, there'll be a real argument between these two scores, and there'll be a real confusion. And that's what I'm quite frustrated about, that as movie fans, we can't really go online and find honest aggregated scores, because the websites manipulate the scores. They don't add up all the numbers, and then, so let's say they get 100 movie critic scores, they don't take those 100 scores and divide it by 100. They increase it and call it a fresh tomato and inflate the scores to make it appear a better movie than what it actually is. So it's quite frustrating. But the reviews on Metacritic for Captain Marvel do seem to be quite varied. There are some very good scores from the Los Angeles Times, Chicago Sun-Times, but there is a very poor review here at 38 from New York Post, which basically says it's a very boring and lackluster performance. So there is a real spread, that there won't be a solid score yet, an average score for some time. But what I'm going to point out to you is that there's going to be a real argument. The fans of Captain Marvel will look at this score, and the people who don't like Captain Marvel are going to look at this score. And it's going to be a real argument. But for me, what I want to see is Metacritic wait until Metacritic increases their number of reviews. So they'll go around, they'll collect, their system will collect more reviews. And when it gets to, say, close to 100, that'll give us a much closer picture of what the actual average score is. So it's still early days. I reckon it'll take another 48 hours for it to be completed. The first early reviews are in, and according to Metacritic, it's not great. It seems to be quite a subpar movie that could disappoint many Marvel fans. But again, it's still early days. This score might shoot back up to 80 to 90%. But what I want to point out is that Rotten Tomatoes does inflate the score, so it does make it quite misleading. But we'll see what happens. So I'll put links below to these two web pages from Metacritic and Rotten Tomatoes, so you can see for yourself. And what I'd really recommend is just go through this review, read through what these people are saying. Because if you see here, for example, they'll give it a rating 7 out of 10, but they'll call it a fresh tomato. Now, if you see here, so that's 80%, that's 70-odd%. So how can these 70 and 80% scores add up to 87%? It's because they inflate the scores. So best thing to do is really to read these through, and they split it between fresh and rotten. So it's completely misleading. So like I say, it's still early days, but for me, the best example, the best result will be Metacritic to go by. So we'll be interested to see what happens, but it's still early days. But for me, it's not looking that great. Well, we'll see how it happens.